To this webinar, an introduction to UiPath process mining. My name is Remco, and today I want to show you what you can achieve by using process mining for your organization. In order to do this, we're going to go over a couple of topics. First of all, we're going to start with why process mining. Then we're going to have a look at the basics of process mining. And after that, we're going to look at a couple of real-life examples of what process mining could mean for your organization. So, first of all, why process mining? Process mining is an area of business intelligence that's focused on the improvement of your business processes. And in most cases, these processes are way more complex than you think, than you actually think in the beginning. On the left side, you see what we typically call a blue book example of process, where it's a straight through process consisting of a number of steps. But if you look at a practice, then these business processes are actually quite more complicated. And thus, this means that any improvements that you try to make to the process really depend on what the process actually is and not that expected process that you have in your head. Process mining is a technique that allows you to really visualize and show the actual real process, thus improving your improvement efforts. So, why do people really start using process mining? Well, one of the reasons is to increase efficiency. By making changes to the real process, you will have a better use case of improving that efficiency than when you're acting on a presumed process. Then the next step is reduce risks. So by visualizing and getting grips and control on your real process, you are reducing the risks in your end-to-end business process. The next thing that people do is maximize the ROI for automation, and that's also loosely coupled to the acceleration of the RPA program. By using process mining, you can identify the real bottlenecks, for instance, in your system. In your process. And by employing automation or RPA to the bottleneck, you will have a bigger impact on the improvement that you're getting for your process. And the last is the focused business efforts around business outcomes. With process mining, you tend to look at the business process end to end. It gives you a complete overview and thus allowing you to better focus on the business outcomes. So, in short, how does it work? With process mining, we take fact-based insights and we provide them based on data or information that's stored in your IT systems. So previously, some business improvement efforts would take, for instance, interviews. They would talk to people and try to figure out that way how the process was running. But by using process mining, you can use factual information from your IT systems. So we use the information that is recorded during the execution of the process. So most companies, for instance, have an ERP system that tracks everything that's been done for instance, a financial process. When an invoice is approved, when an invoice is received, that is recorded in that system. And that is the information that we use in order to execute process mining. So what are the three main data attributes that we need in order to execute process mining? So first of all, something that we call a case ID. So a case ID is the unique item, the thing that you're tracking through the process. So if we think of a financial process, for instance, that would be an invoice number. Is unique for a single invoice and that's going through that process. Next thing that we need is an activity. So an activity is something that has been executed related to that case ID. So for instance, if we go back to the invoice, it's either receiving the invoice, it could be approving the invoice, it could be paying the invoice. So those are the activities related to that specific case ID. And then the last thing that we definitely need is the timestamp. And the timestamp tells you when that activity was executed. So for instance, when that specific invoice was paid, when that specific invoice was approved, or when, for instance, we collected additional data for that invoice. During the execution of the project, we usually see a lot of more data being used. For instance, the user that's responsible for the invoice, that may be actually a normal human user, or it could be a robot that's executing that activity. We could have a look at the supplier for who the invoice belongs to. We could look at the amount of the invoice, and that could help us distinguish between the different types of invoices, for instance, small invoices or large invoices, which may have different ways of being executed within the process. All these kinds of additional data will help you make better and deeper analyses of the process, but the three that we really need are these three. So, how does it work in practice? In practice, the first step that we do is connecting to the data, getting the relevant data for the process. Like I said before, usually this is a backend system, but it could also be multiple backend systems combined with a CSV or an Excel or any other type of digital input. Next step is actually configuring this data and configuring the KPIs for the process. Together, we combine these and through our connector, put them into the applications. The next step is then gather the insights. So based on the configuration of the data, you will end up with a collection of dashboards that provide you with insight on how your process is actually running at that point. And then the next step is acting on those insights, so acting on the facts. And this is a step that sometimes is forgotten, but it's a very important one. Acting on the insights that you get from process mining helps you realize the potential. Otherwise, it's just only insights and you won't actually be improving your process. So within process mining, we distinguish three main areas of focus. First is discovery. Next one is performance or enhancement. And the last one is conformance. And we'll go into each of them in a little bit. So discovery is really discovering the way that your process is actually running. And this is what the process mining algorithms do. They show you a comprehensive and complete overview of the way your process is actually running and not how you think it is running. And the performance enhancement part. So since we have the data containing the timestamps, the users, we can easily automatically identify bottlenecks within your process. You can identify single points of failure or single points of contacts. And it provides you with a good overview of the real complexity within your process, thus giving you points where you can work on performance. And last one is conformance. And this is more on, are we really doing the things that we're supposed to be doing? So most people have a reference model internally about how their process should run. The conformance part of process mining allows you to compare what is actually going on against your reference model to see where you are deviating from your reference model and find out if this should be acceptable or not.